Good day, everyone. We are the group 4, and our topic is all about ridge tracing and whorl tracing. So ridge tracing also apply in whorl patterns, and we all know that we have different types of whorl patterns that we will be encountering, especially that we are dealing with fingerprints. There are plain whorl, the central pocket, the double loop, and the accidental whorl. So what is this ridge tracing all about? So ridge tracing is a process of determining the ridge that originated from the left delta, following the right delta or near the point, and determining the numbers of intervening ridges between the trace ridge and the right delta. So there are important factors that we must consider in doing ridge tracing, and first of it is determining the location of the deltas. We must first identify and look for the two deltas of the whorl pattern. Just like the loop pattern, upon determining the delta and the core, we're going to draw an imaginary line between them and count the intervening ridges between the delta and the core. So that's for the ridge counting. And here in ridge tracing, before we do the ridge counting, we must first trace the ridge from the left delta to the right delta, and we're going to stop the tracing at the near point of the right delta. And then we're going to draw an imaginary line and count the intervening ridges between the trace ridge and the right delta in order for us to determine whether the whorl pattern classified as inner, outer, and meeting. And in order to deeply understand about our topic, we are going to discuss later the rules of ridge tracing. And right now, we're going to focus on the three kinds of ridge tracing, the inner, outer, and meeting.
The inner is the first of the three types of ridge tracing. The ridge trace is inside the pattern area, and there are at least three ridges intervening between the ridge trace and the right delta. To begin ridge tracing, we must identify or locate first the two deltas. So this is an illustration of inner. And this is the left delta and the right delta. The rule states that ridge tracing should always begin from the left delta and end at the right delta. This ridge will eventually become the tracing ridge. As previously stated, contains at least three or more ridges between the ridge trace and the right delta. In this illustration, there are four ridges, and the tracing ridge goes above or inside the right delta. Second is meeting. In meeting, there are less than three ridges intervening between the ridge trace and the right delta, whether or not the ridge trace is inside the pattern area. As previously stated, we will begin with the left delta. So this is the left delta, and this is the tracing ridge. As we've seen this illustration, the ridges that intervene between the tracing ridge and the right delta are less than three ridges.
So next is the outer. So outer, the ridge tracing is outer if the ridge trace is outside the pattern area below the right delta. And there are at least three ridges intervening between the ridge trace and the right delta. So here is the example. This one is a plain whorl. And we're going first to identify the deltas, the left delta and the right delta. And then below the left delta, we're going to start the tracing. So let's trace, going to continue until we reach the near point of the right delta. So here, and then we're going to draw an imaginary line. And then we're going to count the intervening ridges between the ridge trace and the right delta. So there are 1, 2, 3, and 4. So according to the rule, there are at least three ridges intervening, it is considered outer, and the ridge trace is outside the pattern area.
So this whorl pattern classified as an outer.
And next, we're going to discuss the rules in ridge tracing. Rule number one.
This is an example of an accidental whorl. If there are more than two deltas, it automatically applicable in our accidental whorl. And the first rule is locate the left delta for accidental whorls where there are three or more deltas and disregard the center delta. Okay, this is our left delta. Left delta. And this is our right delta. Right delta. And this is our center delta. Okay. We need to disregard the central delta. And tracing is always begin from the left delta until the extreme right delta is reached.
Rule number 2.
If the delta is an ending ridge or circulating ridge, consider it as a starting point and trace the same towards the right delta. So based from the definition, if the delta is an ending ridge or circulating ridge, we consider it as a starting point. Therefore, based from the illustration, the delta there is not an ending ridge, but it is circulating ridge. Therefore, I start the tracing towards the right delta. And always remember that in step 2 in ridge tracing, you must see first the delta if it's ending ridge or circulating ridge, so that we can easily trace our ridge towards the right delta. Rule number 3 in ridge tracing. If the delta is an island ridge, look for the ridge immediately below and trace towards the right delta. So as we can see from the definition, if the delta is an island ridge, look for the ridge immediately below it. So first thing to do is first determine where is the island ridge. After it, if we already determine where is the island ridge, we must look the ridge immediately below. Therefore, based from my illustrations, after I determine the island ridge, I immediately look below it. Therefore, I can easily trace to the ridge towards the right delta. So based from my illustration, it clearly give us details about the rules in ridge tracing of rule number 3.
So the fourth rule is, if the ridge being traced suddenly ends, the next ridge below it is taken as the continuation. So this is where the ridge being traced ends. We trace here, and then according to the fourth rule, the next ridge below it is taken as the continuation. So we trace below it until we reach the right delta. So the fifth rule is, if the ridge being traced bifurcates, the lower branch is considered as the continuation. So this is where the ridge bifurcates, and then we trace here and then here. According to the fifth rule, the lower branch is considered as the continuation. So we trace in the lower branch here until we reach the right delta.
Rule number 6. In tracing a double loop or accidental whirl wherein the ridge being traced will have to rise and recurve near the delta, stop tracing at the upward direction in the line of the right delta. Do not continue tracing down the ridge. So this is our right delta here. So we will start tracing here up to here. So it says that stop tracing at the upward direction in the line of the right delta. So here, this is the upward direction in the line of the right delta. So we will stop here. Rule number 7. Count the ridges intervening between the ridge trace and the right delta. Do not include the ridge trace and the delta. So this is our ridge trace here, and this is our delta. So we will start counting from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are 7 ridges.